In this video, we're going to learn how to set up a minimap inside of your game. I'm working on a top-down RPG-style game, but this should be able to transfer to whatever games that you are working on. So let's get right on into it. The first thing that we're going to need, I'm going to have a minimap folder here, and I'm going to create a scene. I'm going to call it minimap, and it is going to be of the type canvas layer. We can call this our minimap, which is good. We are going to have a control, which we're going to call UI. And we're going to set this in the top right over here in our anchors. Go to our layout. Let's just make sure that all this stuff is good. Horizontal. We can expand it. And that should be good for now. Then we're going to have a margin container, which we are going to want. We want anchors in here. We're also going to have top right. And let's just make a couple of changes in the custom to the offsets. So our left is going to be negative 90. Then we're going to have top is going to be 10. The right is going to be negative 10. And the bottom is going to be 90. So that's going to be the size of the minimap that we're going to see. As a child of that, we're going to have a subviewport container, which needs a child of subviewport. Subviewport container, we are going to give it a custom minimum size of 80 by 80. And we do want to make sure that stretch over here is checked to be true. In our subviewport, we want to make sure that our render target mode is on always, so that's good. And then we want our background to be transparent. And that should be all that we're going to need there. Then as a child of that, we're going to add a camera 2D. I am going to rename this the mini map camera. And here, all we are going to do is affect our zoom. We're going to be 0.2 across the board. And position smoothing is going to be enabled. And we're going to do 12 pixels each for our speed. Another child of the subviewport is going to be a color rect. This is going to be what we're going to call our player marker. So I'm not using a sprite or anything for this. That can be totally up to you if you want to use that for this. But right now we're just going to use a black square. Then in our layout, we can go to transform. And our size is going to be just a 6. So it's going to be a tiny pixel. And then we are going to go in, this shouldn't really matter because we're going to fix the position of our marker in the code. But let's go to our anchor offsets, and we just want to make this 3 left, 3 top, and let's do 3s across the board. Actually, you can't see that, so there we go, 3, 3, 9, 9. We want mouse filter to be on ignore. We don't want our mouse clicks on top of the minimap to do anything. And then the last thing, this is going to be just a like security check to make sure that this is going to be on the top layer of everything. We are going to put, I'm just going to put this on 15, so it's on a Z index. It's going to be higher than everything else. Now we can attach a script to this. We call it minimap.gd. And we need to get our player marker, our minimap camera, our subviewport, and our subviewport container. And these need to be onReady variables. We're going to have one regular variable, which is going to be our player node, which we're going to get in our level script. And then in our ready method, what we're going to do is we need to loop through the tile maps that are within our level. So in my scene, I have a node that is carrying all of my tile maps. So if yours isn't set up like this, you might have to do this slightly differently, but you should still be able to get the picture as to how you can get the specific tile map that you want. So we're going to loop through tile maps in our owner, which will end up being our example scene. We're going to get node. I'm going to give it the name of tile maps, which is what mine is named. And then we're going to get the children here. And then if the tile map dot name equals ground, we're going to get a variable called minimap tile map, which is going to be equal to our tile map dot duplicates. We're going to make a copy of this. And then we are also going to get a variable that's called used rect, which is a rect to I. And we're going to get tile map dot get used rect. We're going to use this used rect to make sure that our camera bounds from within our minimap don't go too far in any given side, so you don't have that default color. It's going to cut off at the end of your used tile map. But it's important that you select the one that is the furthest reaching. That's why I have my ground in my example scene. All of this stuff around here is on my ground tile map. Then we can go into our process, and we're going to do if we have a player node, we're going to get our map camera or our mini map camera. We get the global position, and it's going to equal to lerp minimap camera dot global position, comma, player node dot global position, comma, 0.2. And this is going to be how our camera follows the player. And then we're going to get our player marker dot global position. And then we get our player node dot global position. Now we need two more methods to ensure this is going to work. We need our setup minimap, which is going to take in a minimap tile map, which is a tile map layer. I'm not going to return anything. And then the other method is going to be set minimap limits, which gets our used rect, which is a rect to I. And we don't return anything here either. In setup minimap, what we're going to do is we're going to take in that minimap tile map, which is the duplicate. We're going to go to our subviewport. We're going to add a child. It's going to be our minimap tile map. And that's actually it. It probably didn't need to be in a method, but I kind of like separating it since it has a specific use. And we're going to do setup minimap and toss in our minimap, or not our minimap camera, our minimap tile map. And then in our minimap limits, what we're going to do is we're going to get our map camera, our minimap camera. I'm going to set the limit left equal to the used rect dot position dot x times 16, which 16 are my tile sizes. Then we get our minimap camera limit top, and it's going to be equal to used rect dot position dot y times 16. I'm going to copy and paste these twice to speed this up. So we're going to do, then we need our limit right. We need our limit bottom. And then this one here in the limit bottom, I'm going to put these in parentheses here, still have that multiplied by 16, but we're going to also add the used rect dot size dot y. So that's the difference in the limit bottom. Then we're going to do something similar in our limit right, except we are going to do this on the x for both instead of the y. Now the last thing we need to do is make sure that our player node is being properly assigned into our minimap. So in my example scene, I'm going to drag my minimap scene into the scene. Okay, it should be fine down there. And then we're going to go into the level script. So I have a really basic level script here. What we're going to need is we're going to need a reference to our player, which mine is called top-down player. And we're going to need a reference to our minimap. And then inside of our ready method, the only thing we have to do is if we have a minimap and a top-down player, we're going to go to a minimap player node is going to be equal to our top-down player. Okay, and now we should be able to play our scene. And there you have it. A really basic minimap. So I'm only having the ground tile maps on here. So as you can see, this water tile map is not showing up right now. There is a way that we can fix that though. So why don't we give that a try right now? So the only reason that we're seeing the ground right now, it's because in our minimap script, we're only setting up the tile map, which is only going to be ground. So really what we should be doing is we want to be looping through all of our tile maps. And then we only Oh, and I also forgot the camera limits. Okay, well, that's good. So if the tile map is also ground, then we set up our minimap limits. Okay, now when we go and play this, we have the full tile map. And now you can see when I go down, we see the gray on my screen because I haven't set the camera limits in my game, just on the tile map. So we can go throughout this entire minimap. Or sorry, I've only set the camera bounds on my minimap. And you can see the player in the minimap. You may not like that it has all of your exact, you know, you may not want the tents or all these different structures to show up. So there is a way that you can get around that. You're just going to have to tweak the method inside of where we're setting up our tile maps here. So you can just tweak that, and then you should be good to go to customize it as much as you want. You could also add a border. There's a lot of stuff you could do with this. I just wanted to get you the basics so that you can play around with it and customize it how you want.